This is an obviously clickbaity title. You can't just develop a skill like that quickly. Yeah, that's actually 100% what I'm saying. Here's a bunch of photos. None of these took me a super, super long time to get these done. Just download the files because I'm a kinesthetic learner. I have to be hands-on to learn something and it works a million times better. I go through all this trouble setting up and then people don't use it. I see tons and tons of people in business selling photos that have no business being in business selling photos. They show up to a property and take 20 JPEGs straight out of the phone and then send it to people and they're charging for it. That's what some people want, I guess, but I'm doing this really fast to show you what I'm talking about when I say you can be better than these guys like when you're done watching this video. This is what we're gonna get in the end. To give you a crash course, this is how photography works. You have a camera, you shoot in a format called RAW. You don't get to look at it immediately like JPEGs. It shoots everything really flat and ugly. But that's why people don't jump to RAW, because it doesn't satisfy you instantly. However, there's so much more data in this picture because the brights aren't too bright, the darks aren't too dark, and you can see everything. You'll add the color and the contrast manually. Open up Adobe Lightroom. Here's our software. I've already got an example photo in here, but we're gonna go File, Import Photos, and mine is on the desktop. Right here, this is the one I'm giving you, import. This tab is default library. It's just to look at all the photos you've brought in. We're gonna go over to the tab develop. Now we have all our settings we can control with on the right. Don't let Lightroom confuse you, by the way, because at first it'll automatically minimize these and you'll have little arrows and you won't see anything. You want to keep these down so you can have everything visible. Pretty much the first thing I ever do in a photo is add contrast so I can see what I'm doing a little bit better. Next, I'm gonna take down highlights, but not crazy, crazy amounts. If we take it too far, I'm just worried it's gonna do something funny. So here is good. Same with shadows, add a little bit. Whites, we're gonna increase in this photo. Why? Because we have this sunset going on back here. I know you can't see it, but it adds a lot of glow to all this mist in the sky. This is something I've learned from just photography principles, like how to light stuff and good conditions to shoot for. You don't have to be an expert at that. That takes a while to catch on to. Like, it's just a time thing. And I have enough videos talking about how to do that. So right now, all I'm showing you is the editing. Next thing I'm gonna do is blacks. And normally I don't say take blacks crazy dark because it just sends everything to the freaking shadow realm. You don't wanna do that. That's the really amateur look. You want shadows to be subtle, but it adds some clarity to the picture. This is really helpful in two situations. One, with all this fog. Two, there's water, and for some reason water just looks so much better when you take the blacks down. It's way, way clearer, so I'm gonna go pretty far here, minus 46. Clarity, amateur look, put this on Instagram. This looks like we're spying on somebody in the shower through a window. We wanna keep this like 35. Vibrance, there's a difference between vibrance and saturation, let me show you. Saturation, you see how orange just went straight freaking mustard? Saturation just adds a ton of power to the color. But vibrance adds a bunch of change in the color. So we have light yellow, dark yellow, middle yellow, green, light green, dark green. It just adds contrast to the color. I only want about 50. Saturation, we can add a tiny bit for good luck. You see how it's actually making everything look way more fall and way more fun, and the blue and the water is really nice. In this instance, I'm gonna say add saturation. Normally I don't, but the only reason I'm saying that is because it looks a million times better. The only drawback is one single color. If everything looked goofy, I'd say can it. We don't need that crap. But because it's just one color that's annoying, that mustard oregano orange, we can fix it. The next thing we're gonna do is this tab right here called HSL. Drop it. We wanna be in the saturation tab. All you have to do is click on this dot and then go right over one of these yellow spots, anywhere that you think is just the worst yellow. Click on it and drag it down and look, it automatically gets rid of all that crazy mustard yellow because it's dragging the color saturation just in that range down. If you want to zoom in to see better, you can press Z and hold spacebar and you can drag around and look at everything. You can see there's cars here, and guess what? That's me right here on this dock hanging out. I'm that red shirt. So much beautiful detail in these in this Mavic Pro 2. 20 megapixels, just beautiful. But the good news is that every single DJI drone shoots RAW, so you don't actually need a Mavic 2 Pro if you can't afford one. You can seriously do 95% as good with a Phantom 3 standard, if you know how to use all the features in it. Something I do in every single photo, drop down detail. Bring up sharpening to here and bring noise reduction up to here. Every photo instantly twice as good, I'm telling you. Skin tones, people, nature, your dog, whatever, will look 1,000 times better. Next, we're gonna drop down the vignette. That seems to be a point I'm happy with, like this, these settings. This changes for every photo, by the way. I'm gonna add contrast a little more, clarity a little more, and it seems like the whites are just a little too bright here. So if you take whites down a little bit, that limits how bright the bright spots are. But in a second, I'm actually gonna take them back up because I want to make that sun glow a little more colorful. It's also not like sunset-y enough, and this was later in the day, so color temperature is going up a little bit. It's important that these whites stay bright because later on, we're gonna take advantage of the difference in the shadows and the brights. If we compare this to our JPEG that we did earlier, it's starting to look pretty similar, but there's a little more contrast in the hill. I'm gonna try and raise the contrast even more and drop exposure a little bit to deal with that. Click on this giant thing called adjustment brush. Make sure your little wheel is not too huge, but big enough. Just draw over the water right here on the bay. I know you can't see it yet, but click in color. And then make the wheel bigger. You can roll with your mouse. And just drag down over the water at the bottom. Just the water, kind of draw. Remember, it's a feather, so it's gonna be kind of soft and blend in. Now, we're gonna take the clarity up like a ton and the saturation. Now we can press close and back down to HSL, and the hue is what we wanna change. So click on this dot, click on the ocean and drag it to make it a tad bit more blue. Yeah, it looks better blue there. We're gonna add one more mask. So click on the mask again. Make sure your brush is just gigantic. Getting closer, just a couple more steps. Now we're just gonna get some high energy masking up here in the corner. Click on this brush and scream all the way in the corner up here all over the sky and make it super bright. The exposure should go up like this. Contrast up, clarity up, saturation, a little more orange, little pink. Just for fun, one last thing, color. Click on this little thing right here and very, very lightly take this just into the pink. Actually, I think I'm gonna do more orange because one, it looks like the sun, and two, we have some conflicting blue here with that orange, and I think that makes a nice little balance. So maybe orange pink. Last thing, take exposure down a teeny tiny bit. I'm done with this, so I'll press Control Shift E, Command Shift E on a Mac. Choose a place to save it to, desktop. I usually resize photos to fit a width of 2560 just because I like to share them online and they're smaller that way. You can also set a limit file size so you're not emailing a 30 gigabyte photo. We'll say 3000, that would be 3 megabytes. And click export. If you have an old computer, it's gonna take like 15 seconds. I suggest you use this break to practice your martial arts. You're now doing a better job than 90% of drone pilots who charge money, so congratulations. You can send it to me if you have nobody else to show it to. Comment, subscribe, I love YouTube. That's for annotation reasons. If you have a request for videos, let me know. Otherwise, there you go. Cool.